Also know about glycation, where sugars of any type join together with excessive proteins and start to create free radicals and together cause disease of every nature as well as premature aging. We also know that candida, a fungal disease that wasn't a disease generations ago, since our immune systems were strong enough to keep this natural occurring fungi that's everywhere on the planet's surface in every environment out of the body. But today, with weakened immune system from the stress loads we have, poor diets, negative attitudes, and polluted earth, we basically have immune systems that aren't strong enough to resist it. If you feed sugar to your body, be it carrot juice, organic, be it organic fruit, and certainly not something as vile as agave syrup, you can be assured you'll perpetuate candida and other diseases like cancer, viruses, mold, yeast, fungus, etc. What you also have to know is that every one of us today are most concerned with youth and diabetes. 2 out of 3 new cases of type 2 diabetes, which in my generation was called adult onset diabetes, that usually happened in your 50s, 60s, or 70s, is now commonly happening in 6 and 8 and 10 and 15 year olds because they've lived so poorly in their short lifespans, sitting in front of screens, televisions, taking soda pop and candy bars. What happens is they end up with type 2 diabetes. We now know that 2 out of 3 are going to be the next generation of the people with the largest and most significant diseases. Our healthcare system is being taxed economically at a level today we cannot endure. You wait until the baby boom generation is gone and Generation X's and millenniums move in. We know that every known disease to man is perpetuated and fed and actually attracted to and created by sugars. Let's talk about different kinds of sugars. The one who's gotten the bad rap rightfully is white sugar. But people who are not that conscious may think brown sugar is better. A little bit more, quote, conscious people will say maple syrup will be, or xylitol will be. Others, of course, will say honey is. Now let's give you some real statistics. If I were a scientist from another planet and I came to the planet Earth and never saw any form of sugar and I went into a laboratory, here's what I would find. White sugar is 100% sugar. Brown sugar is 98.7% sugar. Honey of all kinds, that doesn't matter what type, is 98% sugar. Maple syrup is 65 to 68% sugar. Xylitol from a birch tree, just like maple syrup from a maple tree, is 68 to 70% sugar. Agave syrup, when tested by legitimate laboratories, not salesmen in the vegan and raw food community, was found to be more vile in creating low blood sugar and type 2 diabetes than high fructose corn syrup, which is sugar taken from corn that's in most of the processed foods that we consume in the mainstream today. Soda pops, in Europe, as an example, when they tested in England and looked at the New England Journal of Medicine's long-term research, found that the obesity level with children was directly linked foremost to the sugars called high fructose corn syrup in their pops and sodas. I can go down this list, but let me assure you, any form of processed sugar, the body doesn't differentiate. It doesn't care if it's white sugar or organic honey or agave syrup, which none of it is raw, by the way. Another big lie precipitated upon the public. To extract from the cacti the sugar, they must heat it a minimum of 180 degrees Fahrenheit. That is dead as a doorknob. No such thing as raw agave syrup. But what it is a great diabetic creator, if you want diabetes, or low blood sugar hypoglycemia creator.